Vědom.
What's the plan?
We're gonna try doing what we did yesterday. We're gonna get up on these two glassing knobs overlooking the bedding area that there were three bucks hidden in yesterday. Don killed one of those. But we've been here three times and we've jumped bucks or seen bucks in that bedding area all three times. So it's worth a shot. We were fogged in up on the mountain, so we came low again today. We're looking forward to when we can actually go up high, but this has been a nice area for us to be hunting in when everything else is kind of shut down. So see if we can pull it together.
It's up to you, man.
Well, it looks like a 2-year-old to me.
The guy in the end?
On the left, right?
Far left, kind of with nothing behind him?
Yeah.
If you miss, you're going to sail it. Yeah, I got him.
And what's his rack compared to yours? Is it the same size bear or not?
I guess I'm not sure which one you're looking at, Cody.
If he falls on his toes, he's going to be exposed
to that one.
That bigger one right there, right in front of him.
That's a long ways away. Oh, the dead juniper?
Because if he follows on his toes, he's going to be exposed to shit.
He's looking.
He's super open right now.
He's looking our way.
If he falls on his toes, we should be able to get a crack at him easy.
Yeah, those does are up on the hill there, Cody. Going right. If he follows them, you're not going to have a shot.
Yeah, if you walk left, I'm going to try. He'll have to go downhill.
Did you rain? No, the does are right. He's facing the... The does are a ways away from the right. They're going up the hill.
We're going up the hill. Shouldn't we have a shot if we go up the hill?
Yes.
Okay. Should I lay down and hope he goes up the hill? That's a nice buck. That might be the buck we saw here.
Yeah, he's about 280. He's about 280.
Oh.
Hold on. You got him? I think he shot high.
He's still there, Cody.
He's standing right there. He's going right.
He'll stop. Right there.
He's in the wide open.
Right there.
You hit way behind him. He's over top. We can go over there and look over.
I went 0.7, which is, it's for 300, but.
The first shot you hit right over top of him.
Yeah.
Pretty sure.
Yeah, I mean, he tried it. He didn't act like he was hit.
He didn't know what was going on.
I think we should probably.
We might be able to get over that hill and see where he's at, Cody.
He didn't really know what was going on. Nice deep forks on him.
Yeah.
Got the spotter out, I bet it's 30 plus 50 feet.
Give us the game plan here.
All right. We just parked the truck at the spot, basically where Coulter shot his yesterday, and where we tried going as a group earlier in the week, but kept getting fogged out. So we just got out of the truck. We were looking around. There's cows everywhere. And just pulled up the binos and ended up seeing, looks like at least 5 or 6 deer bedded on the side of the hill in the sun. They're tiny in the binos, but we picked them out. Coulter's getting the spotter set up. We'll see if we can see any racks from this far away. See if the racks are big enough to actually see. So we're not gonna be picky today. This is our second to last day, and we're supposed to get a big storm tomorrow. So we'll see how it goes. Right now, you can take a look.
You said there's 5, but there's some grass going to the right that you might pop through here.
Yeah, I
see
4.
It's zoomed out. Yeah.
Drop back over this ridge, come around the back side of this ridge, and hopefully pop out where we can get a better look at them and be closer to in range. We'll find out. Shoot them up. Kind of a V in between where the ridge drops off and then comes back up in the little island.
Saddle.
A saddle. So I guess, yeah, we're on the saddle. We're coming around and there's a little bench that comes up. And I think that first group of deer, second group of deer we saw, is right over there. So we're going to creep up here, get behind a juniper, hopefully be able to see him when we crest that hill.
Wind's right in our face.
Yeah, wind's perfect. Coincidentally. Yeah, and if this doesn't work out, we got another group of deer back there we can go check out, but we aren't sure what these deer are, but they're in the same location, might be the same group that Coulter picked one out of yesterday, so we'll see. He had a couple little brothers, so it's over there. Up. Well, we had 7 does, and then 2 more does came up from the bottom, and then a little spiker came following him up. He's pretty small. We're not sure what to do yet. But they're at like 475, so we're gonna have to close the distance a little bit. But should be able to shoot from 400 as long as we can get a nice steady rest, so stay tuned.
You hit him. You hit him. He's coming down towards us.
Yep. I see him.
Get another one in him. Get another one in him. He's standing there.
He's standing. He's just
get over here.
He's just standing.
He's standing right down low there.
He might be going down.
You missed.
He didn't even move.
He didn't even.
Shoot him again?
If he's standing there, I'd shoot him. Swing over here, man. Just take your time. He's just standing there. Oh yeah, he's going down. Keep shooting.
Go over and get another shot.
Come on, Cody.
Did he go down?
No, he's down in the bottom. We're going to shells.
I only got one more.
Coming down like this. like that rock face. I thought he hit him with the first one, too. I thought he hit him out of the first and the third. Just the way he reacted. Sounded like that first one you hit on.
Yeah, I thought it was too. And then he just stood there.
Oh my god.
Dude, we got a nice buck down.
Yeah, buddy.
Nice spot. Now you spotted him up top and spotted him now.
Oh. Go get our packs, Colt.
He's like, what happened? What's going on?
I ain't grabbing all of them.
Oh man. Yeah, he had a broken leg.
Yeah.
I could see it flopping.
What?
Where did he jump out of?
Right here.
He didn't move far at all.
Who cares about that one?
His buck's dead. Hopefully.
You got another one in?
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't get any of that on camera because we were watching it.
Oh, well. Fucking three. That last one, I was like on his head when I hit him. I'm like, ah! Hopefully I didn't blow his brains out.
Oh, as long man. As he's not running anymore, that's all that matters.
That's so fucking cool, man. Thank you, Fox. Is it not the exact same thing that happened with you? Waiting on that little one and then...
Something else steps out.
There's blood right here. Came out of here. We were real close.
This is You should see the buck over here.
He's still breathing. Yeah, I might have shot a tine off. Look at that top one. Should I shoot him?
Yep. Yeah.
Find him.
He ain't coming back from that one.
No.
Should I shoot him?
Yeah.
Did you see the look out of his eye?
Oh,
no. He was like, oh no. First mule deer buck, my friend. In the worst spot on the mountain.
He just shot his tine off. Freaking awesome though. That was an adventure.
Down, three. And then I did it.
All right, Mr. Norton, walk us through this bad boy.
All right, well, we were up on top, waiting to shoot a doe, with the fog rolled in, before we ended up getting a shot on her. So we sat there, hung out for, I don't know, probably 20 minutes or so.
More than that,
yeah, 20, 30 minutes, and finally, the fog started clearing. Just got back on the bag, got ready, and the doe group that we had been watching had moved. We saw a couple other ones, trying to figure out where everything had moved to in the fog. And then Don all of a sudden said, "Whoop! There's a buck, nice buck." And he was coming up right out of the bottom is what it looked like. So I ended up having to scoot up so I could see down lower. I think you ranged him.
Right? Yep.
He was about 300 yards. So scooted up on the bag, held it at the right amount, and pulled the trigger. And hit him on the first one. Not sure where, he's got a few holes in him. Then we ran up to get closer so we could see farther down because he started heading down. And he was just standing there and shot it two more times. The third shot definitely seemed decent, like we hit him. Then we came down that face over there, which was fun, and started searching for him. Got up on this ridge here, and all of a sudden we were getting close. Don was reviewing footage, trying to figure out which juniper he was by when we shot. We started working up, and then we jumped him out of there and shot two more times. One of those shots, he got a little excited and blew off the tip of one of his tines, but I guess that's the first time I've done that. It's kind of...
character.
Yeah.
He broke that off fighting.
But then he came over and we ended up having to shoot again. And then shot him in the neck to finish him off. He was a tough guy. And I didn't obviously must not have hit him right where I wanted to. So, which is too bad. But we got on him as fast as possible and got him finished off, so I'm blown away. We were totally planning on shooting a doe, and then all of a sudden the fog cleared and he stepped out. So I mean, more than I could have hoped for on basically our last day. There's a storm rolling in tomorrow and we don't even know if we're gonna get up the mountain. So, and now we're definitely not going up the mountain. So,
well, there's a lot of going up the mountain that we're doing today.
Yeah, but on foot.
We're going up this thing.
Yep. Yeah. Nice and...
glad I packed one out yesterday. I'll see if Ryan will tell you guys how to do it.
Yeah. Colt's all warmed up, so should be good.
He's limbered up, ready to go again.
But yeah, we'll have to break him down and get him back home. We'll be staying in a nice warm cabin tonight. It's going to be perfect. Absolutely perfect. So, $3, three guys, couldn't have went any better.
Can I get a year in the kill zone?
You're in the kill zone.
Side two. Grouse and ducks in the fall. Then deer camp in November.
Well,
got him ready.
He's loaded up.
where the rivers run and the eagles fly, and the dogs hang on the leash, where the northern lights dance in the sky, as we lay out some hidden beach on a mountaintop just out of town, and there ain't a building in sight. My guitar as the sun goes down. Am I?